Okay, let's type in benchmark. And 2-2 benchmark. Okay, that's what it was. Nice. Allowed to access photos. Yeah, that sounds good. That's weird. Take photos and video. Manage calls. That's weird. Also, it's just a benchmark thing, but whatever. Add a home screen. No thanks. Verification, AI test, my device. I guess install and test. Download plugin. Fuck me. Okay. And wow, that's big. So let's pause this. And we're done downloading.
Walking into the church this morning, the foyer. Can we give it up for all the people who served and made that happen? It's a wonderland out there. I love it. And I think about the tradition.
Good Lord. I didn't even shut to see if my recent apps were. I don't know if we've got any apps running in the background. Should have probably checked that before I ran this. Oh well. Well, while we're waiting, speaking of Huawei, got the Huawei MateBook X Pro. Love this thing. 3x2 aspect ratio. Jeez, so good.
Alright. next year. Razorbacks next year. We're down to one kid. That's it. One kid. Stand up, young man. We're proud of you. Stand up. We got one. Give it up. We still believe. Maybe you should be the next head coach. And Kiffin's out. Don't get Les Miles. I will tell you, he is not the best coach, but let's move on. How many are ready for the word? Anybody ready for the word? I got to say that this particular talk, it is certainly not a talk, it's a sermon. But I'm not going to scream it at you, and it's not going to be mean, and it's not vindictive. But it does come from the bottom of my heart. And but before I go there, let me tell you about the beginning of next year, 2020. It's an important time of year, and in fact, people come from around the country, different pastors, to try to see what's going on here at New Life Church, and we do that too. So it's not because we're fantastic. People come in to study what we're doing. We do the same thing, but it is common for us to have different people coming in to study. But let me tell you what they miss. They miss the importance of prayer and fasting. We start out our year every year. If you're new to this church, you don't know about this, but everybody else does. And we start out our year with prayer and fasting. It's not a spooky time, but we believe Jesus fasted. We also believe that he taught the disciples, that's what he said. He said, hey, when you go out there, the reason why you're still having struggle in certain areas is because prayer is not enough. In certain areas, you need prayer and fasting. You can see in Israel, some of the kings, the way they would declare a fast when their nation was in trouble, when they had gotten off track. See, kings as young as 16 years old were able to ace it as a king because they would seek God in prayer and fasting. So Jesus said, when you do these things, do it in prayer and fasting. So he basically asked for us to have that in our lives. So it's not something crazy that we do, but it's a week that we push the plate away to a degree. Some people just do desserts for that week where they don't eat desserts. Some people, they may just eat one meal a day. A lot of people choose a fast where they only eat after 3 o'clock, just one meal a day in the evening. I don't know how you're going to participate in the prayer and fasting, but fasting is related to food. But through the years, other things have migrated in to what we do, and that is some people push away social media, and they don't participate in that for an entire week. Young people, can you imagine not being on Instagram for 7 straight days? I don't know if the world can keep spinning, but I do know that we get involved in that aggressively, and Netflix and Xbox and all these things, ESPN, and but it's going to be a season that we give God our undivided attention. So the reason why I'm telling you about it now is because you can't just stumble into a season of fasting. You have to think about it. And so I'm letting you know early. I'm now 58 years old, and I don't know if this is the fourth quarter of ministry for me. I don't know, but I do know that I think about everything differently than I used to. I think about the fundamentals a lot more, which is precisely what I want to speak to you about this very day. I've entitled it, A Closer Walk with Christ with Your Daily Devotion. In fact, if I were to ask you, how is your daily devotion going? I'm convinced that a lot of people struggle with this. I'm convinced that sometimes you ace this and other times you do not. But to encourage you, I'm also convinced that a lot of you love the Lord with all your heart, soul, and strength. If you love Jesus, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, then would you clap to the Lord? Because the Bible says to clap your hands, all you people, and shout unto God with a voice of triumph.
QR test. Okay.
I know you love him, but I also know you're not growing in your relationship with God at all if there's not regular time with him. Some people are very much into the Word. We have people that are in this church who might have large portions of Scripture memorized. I have met people who have had the entire New Testament memorized. And Mel Amrine, a lot of the Old Testament as well. But you can take somebody who knows the Word, and if they go 30 days without having regular devotion with God,
Okay. Temperature monitor, 35°C. Right on. Well, the screen brightness is at full, I think, during the whole test. Yeah, the screen brightness is at full the whole test. Doesn't really feel warm. And then, what was I running in the background? Play Store and YouTube. Okay.
Speaking. I don't like it. I never have. But it's not really speaking.